The biomass passes through a chamber which is made of two parallel horizontal tubes. It goes in at one end and comes out carbonized at the other. Except that it's easier said than done, for it's very tricky to introduce the biomass into the chamber without allowing oxygen to slip in at the same time. The machine depends on the biomass. The more biomass it's fed, the more energy is provided to make the machine function. To start the machine, an oil burner heats the combustion chamber up to 500 or 600 degrees Celsius, depending, of course, on the kind of biomass that's being used. To keep functioning, the machine needs the biomass to be fed on a continuous basis. And so we introduce it into the machine through a grinder, a hopper, and finally an endless screw. Once the carbonization temperature is reached, the burner is turned off, and all the pyrolytic gases, as we call them, are diverted to the post-combustion chamber, where they're mixed up with heated air to ensure their combustion. The resulting heat is used to maintain the optimal carbonization temperature throughout the operation of the machine. With our machine, there are no methane emissions and all the CO2 is recycled. All the toxic pyrolytic gases are entirely burned off in the combustion chamber and serve as a self-feeding source of energy. In terms of influence on the climate change, our technology is totally neutral. It could become a very profitable enterprise and create jobs, since people could be paid to collect biomass, which is not being done at present. Additionally, this activity could become even more profitable in the short and medium term because of the revenues that would be generated by carbon credits through reducing methane emissions.